In the last video, we made a bursting and spawning system. For this video, we'll try to replicate combustion to get it closer to real-life firework. So, what do I mean? Well, let's pay close attention to the behavior of these stars. Here is a video clip of actual fireworks. Can you spot the difference in motion? Well, the stars in geometry node is basically moving until it perishes, but actual fireworks stars seems to come close to a full stop. So why does this movement halt happen? Even if an object encounters air resistance, it should still be moving at terminal velocity. Well, I believe it is happening due to combustion. I am no physicist or a fireworks researcher, so I cannot provide numbers, but since these fireworks stars are converting its mass to light and heat, it is losing mass with progression of time. If we revisit the drag deceleration formula, we see that mass is in the denominator, which means as the mass gets closer to zero, deceleration reaches infinite and star comes to a halt. Okay, enough with the lectures. We will reproduce this halting behavior by replicating mass change of combustion. However, since I do not know each and every chemistry formula for each metal used, I'm just going to simplify. First, let's add another attribute in init shell group. For this, I'm just going to duplicate the mass store named attribute and just change the name to mass init. Mass init represents the initial mass, and mass without init is the mass at current frame. Mass should be updated every frame, but mass init should not be changed after initialization. Next, create a little space after join geometry. We will add a new store named attribute here and update mass. Drag out a map range from this value socket. Drive this map range value using scene time. Connect named attribute tShellSpawn to fromMin. Connect named attribute tShellBurst to fromMax. Connect named attribute massInit to toMin. And set to max to 0. Let's run the animation and see its effect. By muting this node, we can compare the before and after. Without combustion, with combustion. By adjusting parameters, we can make it more obvious. But before we do that, let me address an issue. The 2max value of this map range is set to 0 since when star perishes, it is assumed all mass is lost. What about in case of shells though? It should not lose all its mass since it contains the stars. So shells should retain certain level of mass at the time of burst. So let's differentiate the behavior for shell and star. First, connect switch node to 2max. And connect named attribute bShell to its conditional. For false, If it's a case of star, set it to 0. For true, for case of shell, let's set the terminating mass to 90% of mass init. Let's run the animation. If we change the shell lifetime of star to 2 seconds, we can observe them coming close to halt just before it perishes. Alright, let's group these nodes up. Call it calc mass. This is it for this video, so let's go back and summarize. We only modified the mass calculation and initialization part. For init shell, we added mass init. Mass calculation is as follows. We replicated combustion to refine the point behavior. For the next video, we will make the tail portion of the file works. Thank you for watching. See you next time.